Pokey pokey. So, I'm going to have a go in my letters paper journal with a random 52. Let's try this, see how it goes. Almost black on the window. Now then. I've got no ideas. This could be very interesting. This black window. I mean, I do have a nice stencil that's sort of like an arched window. Let's see if I can find it quickly. This could be quite a dark page, couldn't it? Here we are. It's got a window. Now, got a lot of reddish colours, and we've got sort of a tealy colour up here. Almost black as well. Oh, it's a thinker. I'm just trying to see. See, that looks black to me. I'm wondering if it's supposed to be sort of a Payne's grey. Right. Window. Yep, I'm going to have to go away and think about this one. Because it stumped me. So, I'll be back shortly. Okay, so because the way this stencil is, I think it's more of a mask really, because you'd want this bit to be clear. You wouldn't want to... This is a window, so... What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to use my embossing ink and some UT, and I'm going to try maybe sort of almost like a resist technique today, I think. I don't think I've ever done this before. I think this will be great for this wax paper journal, this kind of idea. Hope that's enough ink there. I'm going to pop down my UT. Loads of it, that's way too much. Right. Now I need my little... It's under here somewhere. Ooh, ow! I'm banging my head on the tripod today. Where is it? Oh, I can't find it. Okay, so I'll just tape onto there. Pop that to one side. I have missed a little bit, but I can go back in just a second. Let me just. Take that back in. Oh, that's one there. Oh, I'm such a messy, messy crafter. Okay. And heat tool comes out right here. You probably can't see that very well, but oh, you can just about see the shine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop my mat back under there. To grab my stencil, lay it back over. And we can go back in. We can put a bit more down. That looks like I've got more of that. That's good. Okay. Let's try not to make such a mess this time. There we go. Pop that down there. Grab my book. that's all my crystals turned. Lovely jubbly. Now what? Now what? Now what? Do I want to use some sprays? Just doesn't look like it's turned there. Let's just get that bit. Got it now. A wash. A wash maybe red. Oh, you know, I really don't know. Excuse you. Would watercolours work? Yeah, let's try some watercolours. Just see how it works. Because I think that's going to work really well with the resist sort of thing. It's not going to sit on the what's it called? Embossing paddle. So let me grab my watercolours and I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm going to squirt the red with a bit of water. Let's sit for a second whilst I find a nice brush. Let's see. Let's just try this one. No. That's being used. No, let's just try some water. There's nothing. Oops. No, I don't think that's really liking the that medium. So let me just grab a baby wipe. So, anew. Have to be acrylics. So let's try. Let's try some acrylics. Let me grab a nice red. And we will see if that works. So we've got dark red. And brush. Add some water. May need to add a little more water. See, matte medium is creating sort of a resist when you do it too watery, so put it on quite thick. Try and blend it quite nicely if we can. And then I need to grab a tissue. Now that's not too bad. Yes. Fine. Just blend it nicely. That's great. Okay, panic over. We've done it. Okay. Now then. Gonna pop some of this paint back into the tube, and then I think maybe come back in with some stenciling or stamping or something like that. Be back in a bit. Okay, so I haven't really done anything, I've just scraped that red paint off and I've just had a thought. So you don't want to, oh, it's on the slide off there, oh no. You don't want to hit this with a heat gun because you'll reactivate your embossing powder. So what I'm going to do is just rub gently on my little panes of glass to get the paint off so they stand out nicely. Yeah, so if you reactivate the embossing powder, it's just going to suck that paint in and you'll never get it out. Whereas if you don't, you can just do this, basically. Get rid of it if you don't want it. You can sort of bring more paint in to go in between the gaps. It would be really handy. A cotton bud or Q-tip. Something like that, something quite fine. To get into the fiddly bits. There we go. Yep, so I'm going to stop fiddling now and leave it to dry and come back. Okay, so I've got this almost brick-like structure. And I'm going to go in with hickory smoke. And I need a, excuse me one second, a sponge. This is going to be my, what is it, almost black. And I'm going to go in these corners, on the edges. And what I think I'm going to do is grab the black as well. And go quite dark on the edges. And then the black sort. And then I'm just going to grab Hickory Smoke again, just add a little bit. Yep, have a hint of that around the rest of the page. There we go. Now what do we do? My brick is quite a dark red. Just wondering if a little bit bit of script stamping. Unfortunately, this one is not in the archival yet. Oh yes. I am definitely going to get more of the archivals when they come out. Have made room for them. Got rid of some pigment inks that I don't use because I have my Tim Holtz now. Loving it. Yes, now I need to stop before I get too carried away. Okay. What's next? Now I think I need to find a quote of some sort. Someone's turned the television on downstairs. Yep, so I'll find a quote and I'll be back. So I'm going to print off my quote here. It's quite a long quote. Going to see if my so I'm going to cut this up. I was looking up quotes about doors and windows, and I can always remember this one because it makes me laugh, so. Okay, so I'm just gonna pop these down. And I was looking for my bone folder, but this will do. Burnish it a little bit. I just thought, you know, it's a bit of a spooky page, dark and so, yeah. So, I think that is going to be that for this page. You can buy these cards from Mike Deacon's website, so I will link that below for you. They're just little prompts. Just to get your creative juices going and all that. and you can go any direction you want, anything you feel. Obviously I'm starting to feel like we should be getting our Halloween decorations out, because I love Halloween, and you know, Halloween yet. I think I just want to maybe, or maybe I'll use a pen. There we go. Is that finished? I think so. Do I want any more stamping? No, I think that's enough. Let's not go too OTT, and you should still be able to sort of see through the window. Nice fun little page in my wax paper journal. Very different to the other quite bright pages, so yeah, made a nice change. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye guys.